that's where Jimmy Lawson lives. And there's where Eddie lives with his... Yeah, this is it for another episode of the investigation of Jack Smethurst in Love Thy Neighbour in Australia 2023. Have a good evening.
Thank you for joining us again for another edition of the investigation of Jack Smethurst. I need to fix this lighting, it's no good. Yeah, that's a bit better. Three, two, one. Welcome to the investigation of Jack Smethurst in Love Thy Neighbour in Australia 2023. Basically, we're celebrating the life of not just only Jack Smethurst, but... Oh, God, let's do that again. I didn't record that, did I? I just recorded it. Shh. Welcome to the investigation of Jack Smethurst in Love Thy Neighbour in Australia 2023. As mentioned before, we're almost coming to an end. I just wanted to thank you for watching these videos up to now, wherever you happen to be. Thank you for watching because it's not only... has it been a pleasure for me to bring you this? I've been enjoying bringing you the series myself, so it's quite sad it's coming to an end. I don't really want it to come to an end, but it... If you want a nice cold beer, oh, it's a cold beer, it's not a warm beer, don't worry. It's full strength, original. I'm really advertising this, I don't know why. Oh, pregnancy warning. Alcohol can cause lifelong harm to your baby. I've never seen any warnings like that before. Lifelong, I don't know about that. Brewed and bottled in Queensland by Great Northern Brewing Company. Made in Australia, beer. And hang on a minute, where is it? Oh no, sorry, I'm not looking at 10 cents, don't worry about that. I'll get something else here. The brewing company should have the alcohol rating somewhere. Maybe on the front. Full strength, brewing. Oh, here, here. My site's going up for alcohol volume, 4.2%. Yeah, 4.2%. You can see it there. I had to look for that. I thought I might be on the back, but they put it on the front.
Come on, Eddie, your beer's going flat.
Hang on, hang on.
You never win the jackpot.
Oh, won't I? Been one before, you know.
Eddie's quite right. My granddad remembers it very clearly.
Come on, come on, come on. Some cherries and two bars. Hey, that followed by two lemons and a melon. I think we're on a winning sequence here, lads.
How do you make that out?
Well, the last time they came up, it was followed by the jackpot.
Well, put your money in. Go on, put your money in.
Would you believe it? I'm out of change.
No, I haven't. How about you, Jacko?
I'll have half.
Change? Have you got any change?
What for?
It's for the... Oh, never mind, I'll get some of the bar. Look, whatever you do, don't let anybody pay that machine.
No, all right. Yeah.
All right. All right, so it's 15th of May. What is this place? I've been here before, a long time ago. 6 years ago, I think. He wouldn't want to be trapped there, would he?
Yeah, okay, so. Yeah, it's the day after Mother's Day. Just trying to find my way somewhere. Got a good idea, right? Oh, look at this. Getting dark again now. You hear all these noises and smell all the food. I can't be just trapped indoors at home and talking to you, because it just doesn't work. It doesn't work. I'm just sitting there going, you know, words just don't come out. The words just don't come out properly. Something happened today. Big time. Big time happenings. Susan Street. Susan Street. Hello, cat. Hello. Oh, I knew I'd find it on my own. Look, we're back to where we were before on the first episode. It's like back to square one. No, not really, because we've done all we needed to do. We've done everything, see? Oh yeah, just out of interest, you can see on episode one or episode two the petrol price, and today this one's giving the petrol at a rate of $1.63 Australian. So wherever you happen to be, let's cross here. Well, we've been here before. You probably recognise this area. I'm not going down there. I'm not doing it. I know you all want me to do it. You all want me to open the door and see what's behind the door. Okay, just hang on a minute, I'll find something. Love Thy Neighbour? Love Thy Neighbour? You must know Love Thy Neighbour.
Before?
Yeah, long time. In the 70s.
When?
In the 70s. When? TV show.
When? Spirit.
TV show called Love Thy Neighbour.
No.
You don't remember?
No.
You used to watch the TV before, Channel 7?
No. Channel 7?
Yes.
Yeah. Mosque. Yeah, maybe she must.
Maybe, yeah. Okay.
Love thy neighbor. Walk up and say, how be ya? Gee, but I'm glad to see your pal. How's tricks? What's new? Love thy neighbor, offer to share his burden. Tell him to say the word and you'll see him through. Especially if there should be a beautiful girl next door. Say to the girl next door, don't think I'm bold, my mother told neighbor, and you will find your labor a great deal easier. Life will be breezier if you love thy neighbor.
What is this place doing?
If there should be a beautiful girl next door, say to the girl next door, don't think I'm bold. My mother told me to love thy neighbor, and you will find your labor a great deal easier. Life will be breezier if you love thy neighbor.
I know where I am.
Make a left onto the path, then in 90 metres, continue on Northumberland Road.
That's the train station.
In 70 metres, continue on Northumberland Road.
I know where it is. We've been there before. We've been there. Yeah. That's the club there, and then... So, there is a sports club. It's a soccer sports club, or a football sports club. There's me, an idiot with a scissors in my pocket. I've got reason for that. Not that. It's not to do with that. It's to open something. If you think that, then that's a bit silly, isn't it? There I am. Oh, there is that silly guy with a blue t-shirt, with that UK thing, Union Jack on his on his... Oh, yeah, that's it. Here we go. Station.
Continue on Northumberland Road. Then in 50 metres, turn right onto the road.
Yeah, I know that. If you remember this, I'll show you.
Oh, I'm right here at the station here. Walk all the way out there. There's Club Auburn. Right-hand side. Was where the old club was before the RSL club.
In 50 metres, turn right onto the road.
She doesn't shut up. So people will just come from work or something and then just coming home. It's a bit of a hard time. This time is a little bit difficult. I've got an idea. I haven't thought about this one before. It's going to direct me to some place which I've never been to before.
In 60 metres, the destination is Auburn.
Shut up.
Excuse me. Sorry, mate. Is the Auburn Soccer Club around here somewhere?
The
Auburn Soccer Club. It's directing me around here somewhere and I don't know.
Auburn.
Oh, that's a club?
Yeah.
For the soccer club?
Yeah.
Is that it? maybe that's it, yeah.
I know. That's
the only club. Is there one here?
It's the only club. Because every time I do the Uber, it's between me on the other side.
Yeah.
I remember this. Oh my god. Yeah, I remember. Okay, so just a bit further up here. Thank you.
because they built the apartments right here.
This is fairly new, this one.
See?
I don't even mean the date. I can't remember the date on, but this one.
The destination is on your left. Auburn Soccer Sports Club.
It's not even here. It's not even here. Lady?
Not here. Oh, hang on. What's this?
Arrived.
Yeah, arrived to what? It's not. It's just units. That's what it is. I'm just looking.
Oh, man. What is this? Oh, this is familiar. I'll chuck a 7 later. Get a beer now. Schooner. Schooner. Yeah. Get a beer, get a kebab, and have a coffee. Cheers. Too easy. Too easy. Okay. So today is a day after Mother's Day in Australia. I placed my order for the Love Thy Neighbour in Australia. And this is why I got the scissors. So I can cut it open nicely and show you. Show you what I got. It's apparently still brand new. Look, look. It could be a shot. Thank you to these people that sent me this. And it was within within a week. This is the one that you see within a week. It got here. If it's, to me, if it was even second hand, didn't matter, you know. It's okay because this one is a rare find. I have to tell you, it's really hard to find this. It looks like it's brand new. Yeah, it hasn't been opened. Okay, by Umbrella Entertainment. I'll show you.
That's the one. That's the green cover. And then, of course, on the back,
all 7 episodes on one disc. So this is the this edition is the Umbrella Entertainment. But I was really looking at the other one. But I believe it to be the same quality. I believe it's the same quality. So, look, there we go. It's a very rare find. And I thank God I've got a brand new one. I found one. A member of family wants the same thing as well. So, to find one brand new like that, I think that's from a DVD shop or some shop. You know, why have they got it in a bag like that? I'm pretty sure it's from a shop. So, that is really good news. I'm so happy about that, that I've got that. And it's probably worth adding it on YouTube. But you're seeing it there anyway, it's there. You can see it. Now the other thing is a bigger package. It all came today, it came today.
Brand new in its package as well. 9 disc set.
So you remember what I said, it had about 50 something episodes? That's all there. 50 something episodes plus a 1973 film. The film's there, digitally restored. And there's the original pilot episode, never seen before. 1972 Christmas sketch from like an all-star comedy carnival, and then the 1973 New Year special. Sometimes some of these shows have New Year specials, or you know, like Christmas specials, something like that. That's it, but that's the one. Nine disc.
There's the little bit of information. That's how many hours I've got to watch. I've got to watch a lot of hours, what, 24 hours? So that's everything there.
The things that say Studio Canal and Fremantle, you know, they're the good companies. So what they've done is pretty much remastered everything. You can take a look at differences, you know, if you've purchased an old one before, you know. But that's pretty much the thing I wanted to show you today, because it's been a good day for me today, because these have arrived at the same time. And one arrived from South Australia, and the other one, which is the big one I've just showed you now, came from, I think that came from Victoria, yeah. My eyesight's not very good. But if you do want more information, I can let you know. I just recommend eBay. I don't recommend anything else. If the seller is 100%, then certainly I recommend the seller that's 100%. Even 99.9 or something. As long as they've sold thousands of DVDs and things, that's good. But there it is. I'll show you again the covers, and that's pretty happy that I've actually finally purchased them. And it's been something like 40 years since I think I told you that I've last seen the episodes. Talking to a member of family about it as well, and said that we've not seen these in 40 years. Showed them the first episode of Love Thy Neighbour in Australia. We were bawling out laughing together. It's you know, we're just having a great laugh, and that was the best, probably one of the best weekends I've had in a long time. Just having a laugh watching it again. And it's just the jokes on there and the laughs, it's good. You can't go without a laugh. And yeah, just watching that again is a blast. I'm going to watch them again. You gotta just keep laughing. Just be happy. Whatever happens, you know. This is a good set to keep in your collection. And cheers. So that's news to me. So remember the conversation I had before with the fellow that knew Love Thy Neighbour? I just had a word with him again, the same guy. And I showed him the DVD. This is the Love Thy Neighbour DVD. He couldn't believe it. And the other guy knew Love Thy Neighbour too. He was singing the tune. So there's a few of them that knew it, and this guy knows. And this club, Club Auburn, used to be across the road, and the name of the club was
Auburn Soccer Club. And it hasn't changed in that. Like, they haven't changed it on the Google Maps. Maybe by the time you watch this now, it's been changed, but no, they haven't changed it. So, Club Auburn, just to let you know, Club Auburn was Auburn Soccer Club. So there it is. There's some news for you. Okay, I'll finish my beer, and then I'm gonna get a kebab. Oh, if only they take an afterpay system, that'll be all right, wouldn't it? You know, if you buy your own home, you can pay it off really slowly.
Well, I hope you know your dinner's ruined.
Well, that's all right, love. I like things well done. Yes, sir.
Good. Get your teeth round that.
Looks very nice, love. Is there any gravy?
Yes, it's that brown stain on your plate.
Well, I'm sure it'll taste lovely.
Be careful, it's hot.
Oh, I can never afford that. Not in my lifetime, mate.
Wonder how long we're going to last in here.
Especially if there should be a beautiful girl next door. Say to the girl next door, don't think I'm bold. My mother told me to love thy neighbor. And you will find your labor a great deal easier. Life will be freezier if you love thy neighbor.
Done for an episode.
Sensational savings. Remember, tell your friends about us, Classic Homewares. A further 20% off every item in the store. These prices won't last, so get in quick.
I like it. I like that when they say, oh no, not 15% off. No, not 20% off. Further 5% off. It's 25% off. When you walk in there, they don't know what you're talking about when you go in. I mean, that was probably the best, worst reverse parking I've ever did in my life. Well, hey. The first few instructors I've had was a Yorkshireman. And then I had a Scottish man. But the Yorkshire guy, he's like, I had a few lessons with him. And then he probably gave up on me because he's got too many other people to teach. And then I had this Scottish man, he was useless. Like, I was at the lights and I was turning right at the lights. And I remember the lights were green. So I was getting ready to get the wheels ready to turn the car. Usually you have to keep them straight. Yeah. I turned them a little bit right and he goes, don't turn it right, we do you? And I thought, what the hell? And then I rang up the company and said, no, I don't want him again. That's it, don't want him. So rude. So you don't need people like that. So you need people to teach you like calmly. So the third one I had, and I failed two tests. The third one I had,
was an Australian guy, and he was like as quiet and calm as you could ever be. And like, and you know what he said to me? He said, I did a reverse parking, and I did all the things that, you know, all the things that I did in one lesson. And he said, mate, I don't know why you didn't pass the test in one go. You're excellent. And I thought, well, I did have enough lessons, but these guys that were teaching me before, oh, forget it. And if they're watching right now, see you later. This coffee place, unfortunately, it's closed. You remember we walked past this lazy monkey?
I'll show you.
One night they were really busy. I think it must have been a Thursday night. And there was people here, and it was all lit up here, quite nice, you know.
That's where Jimmy Lawson lives.
Bloody good drop, this.
That's a funny accent you've got.
Yeah, well, I'm from...
Don't tell me, because I'm red hot on accents. Now, just say something else.
Oh, yeah, well, all right. Well, it's a real nice day here today in Australia.
Got it. Birmingham.
Sydney.
Oh, you're an Aussie.
Yeah, Jim Lawson's the name.
Oh, nice to meet you, Eddie Boone. Well, come with me, old sport. It's real beaut to meet a fair dinkum Bruce like yourself. Good on you, mate.
I've got news for you. We don't talk like that here in Australia.
Of course you do. I've seen it on telly. I used to watch Flying Doctor, you know.
Flying Doctor and a Wagga Wagga. Come in, sport.
And there's where Eddie lives with his...
A bit better. That's a bit better.